Hi everybody, and welcome to my let's play of XCOM 2, the expansion, which is called War of the Chosen. Yes, exactly. A game that is very relevant since it's only 4 years old at this point. I'm going to be playing Iron Man mode on Commander difficulty because I am not good enough for Legend difficulty Iron Man because I just finished my Legend let's play. Not let's play, my playthrough, and I got my ass handed to me a couple of times doing that, and I don't think I'm ready for Legend yet. Okay, let's just start. I wanted to do the tutorial because it kind of gives you a better introduction to the game, but if you do that you can't enable Iron Man for some reason, so we are not going to do the tutorial, and we are going to use that, so we're just gonna start. And I'm gonna be quiet and drink my coffee.
Central. Go.
Yeah, so basically, if you haven't seen XCOM 2 yet, aliens have taken over the world and we are trying to kill them round by round.
Now that we've got a foothold, it's time to take the fight to Ragnet. We're heading into the city center to take down a public target, something that will get people's attention. Neutralize any security forces in the area. Keep your heads down.
Yeah, basically, I've been playing this game non-stop for the past 2 months, I think, and it's just a lot of fun, and I really wanted to do an Iron Man run, but I didn't want, like, at some point I just thought maybe I'd make a Let's Play out of it, and this is actually the reason why I started making YouTube videos again, because I thought it would be fun. I don't know. You can tell me what you think. So, Commander difficulty is, I think, a lot easier than Legend difficulty, in that I think there's a multiplier to if you hit several shots in a row, you get a higher hit percentage than you would, something like that, I don't know. But it feels much easier.
Minus 1-5. We have a fix on the target. Move to place the X4 charges in the designated position.
Okay, so basically, we start out with four people. And we're hidden now, and we will try to go over here and place charges. And we're gonna encounter some groups of enemies. Since we are hidden, we do not want to run directly into these groups of enemies, and we can also not run through windows and doors, or else we'll be discovered. And if we're discovered, then they can have their way with us, which is always not fun. And here you can see the red squares are those that if I walk on them, these people that are standing around will see me. Yes, it's very strange that you can walk pretty much directly next to them, but not exactly next to them. Yeah, so I'm just gonna start out by seeing if I have someone who can go further to the left, was what I was thinking, but I can't, so I will go here in order to maybe find the first pod. Pod is means the first group of enemies, and we
These
did
guys
find
aren't the
them.
bulk of the Advent forces we've dealt with. They're disciplined and well-equipped, but their obedience makes them
So we
hard.
basically have three Advent troopers, which are pretty the standard opponents and more than enough for our idiots that we have at the current moment, and you will see that they even if I do everything as well as I can, I will probably still get some of them killed on this mission. Yeah, so basically we are gonna go here, and it might be a good idea to spread my idiots out. Maybe I will go from above. And there's different types of cover in this game. There's full cover, like you can see the shield of the person on the right. She's in full cover. This means that the enemy is much less likely to hit her than the guy on the left that has half cover. And you just have to find out how it goes. Okay, so basically what we want to do now is try to avoid triggering two pods at once, because they will probably kill us. We'll look at the percentages, so we don't really have very good shot percentages in the beginning of the game. But that gets better as the soldiers progress, and they are complete noobs, so they are extremely dumb and can't hit shit at this moment. I'm going to go over the roof of this one so I have more room, because basically what you want is for everyone to have full cover and to be able to shoot the enemies with the most accuracy. And this person I'm just gonna put into Overwatch, which means they will shoot if they're discovered and somebody moves. In this case, I was actually hoping that this was not a moving pod, but they seem to be walking away, which is always a problem. And now there's one of them that I can't see, so I don't know where I will get discovered by him if I where his red squares are. So I'm just gonna go here. I should probably attack them this turn, so I should probably go into cover, but there is no cover that I can reach here, because if I go to this block here, then I won't be able to shoot them because my character won't have line of sight. I'm just gonna go here and see if I have a somewhat passable shot on them, which is 86% is really good actually. So this percentage is much higher than on legend difficulty. So I'm probably gonna initiate the encounter with her. I don't like doing. So I can see two of the troopers, so I can be. I don't like doing. What you can do is that you attack out of hiding, which. And put everybody else that isn't attacking into Overwatch, which gives you a better chance of hitting them than Overwatch itself. But I don't like that because you can't react to the enemies. So basically, I'm just gonna shoot this dude from here. I think it's fine. And he's dead. Okay, so I have two dudes left. And they are going. One is in full cover and one is in half cover. The guy in half cover is not much of a problem. I can. If I'm sure I can kill the other dude, which I think I can, because I will use a grenade on his cover. Well, whatever. So I'm going to focus on killing the guy who's in full cover because I can pretty much move this dude here. Then I have a flanking shot which has a very high probability of hitting and killing the other guy. I'm going to move her here, and I don't know, don't like that stuttering. Maybe found another pot. I hope not, we didn't. Okay. So basically what I'm going to do is use her to destroy his cover and damage him. If I'm really lucky, it'll kill him, but it probably won't. We'll see. This mission is much easier on. It actually didn't destroy the cover, so this is not destructible cover, which is surprising to me. So we really have to make sure he dies this turn, because he can one-shot my soldiers, which I do not want. Because I assume that there's additional pots on this. But as you can see here, if you have a yellow marker, this means you are at a flanking angle and you have a very high chance of hitting them. I don't think, like, with the complete rookies, it goes much above 82%. And he in full cover is almost impossible to hit with 30%, so I would expect that even the 82% chance is missable. But he hit it, and that is very nice. So we really, really need to kill this guy, because he can. Well, he can't flank my people very easily, but a lot of my people are in half cover, and that's not a good time. So I'm basically gonna use two of my grenades on that pot. I'm gonna move her here and throw a grenade at him. And I hope I don't trigger a new pot, but I think I'm safe here. But the take up. So. And I can't throw that far, which is bad. But I moved her here in addition because I thought that getting close to a flanking angle would actually improve her chances of hitting him. But as you can see, she has a terrible chance. So we'll just have to get lucky in this case. We could also put her in Overwatch. Maybe. I think we'll put her on Overwatch. Maybe he leaves cover and she has a higher chance of hitting him than 26%. Yeah. So now he isn't in cover, and we had a better chance of hitting him, which worked out in this case. So all of my soldiers are now leveled up, which is good. We also have to make sure we get all the loot. I'm kind of scared of going here because I think we have a very good chance of triggering a pot, so I will go here. I hope there's no enemies here because they will see us if we go here and will attack us from the side, which is really bad. But maybe I will see if I can get into full cover to make sure I can get that loot, because the loot is basically weapon upgrades and they're very important, especially, well, they're always very important, but in the beginning your people are just so bad that You need as much help as you can get. I'm just gonna go here because I have a second move. I think I'm probably gonna trigger a pot. Yes. That is a worse pot, definitely. So the Advent officers, what they do is they can mark people, and it gives their people a much higher chance to hit and crit. So even if you're in full cover, it doesn't necessarily mean you're safe. Okay, so I will have to use my second move with this guy to get him into good cover in order to have a chance of him not getting killed. I will move, I think, her here. She still has a grenade, but she probably can't throw far enough to hit anybody. I think the second trooper back there is out of position and might just go into Overwatch. So as you can see, we have very terrible hit percentages now, which is not good. I will try to, and I don't have any full cover in range of my first move. So I will go here in order to get a flanking shot, which has a higher hit percentage. But I kind of think I might lose someone in this round. Okay, so this is only a two-thirds chance to hit, which is not very good, but it's the best one I'm gonna get. So I'm gonna take it, and it missed, which is not surprising to me. I actually, pretty much all of my people are out of position, I'm gonna be honest here. I will also don't have access to full cover at all with her, so I'm just gonna put her here, which is gonna bite me in the ass probably. But at this point, it's like I'm fucked anyways, basically. So basically, I should have waited another turn and not taken the loot at this point. I will use her, put her on Overwatch, with the same hope that the guy runs out and we have a better chance of hitting him. I will take the 45% chance on him because if I don't, then I won't get another one. And everybody's in half cover now, which is basically a really bad place to be. I'm gonna put him here, which puts him on a good angle for him to get shot by the officer. But he's behind full cover. If I put him here, he'll just probably get flanked and killed, which is not good. So I will put him here so he has a better chance, but all of my people are in bad positions now. It is not how this is supposed to go. So he marked her, which means now he and the others have a much higher chance of hitting and critting her, and they will attack her. I hope this hits. It did. That's good. So she's probably gonna die anyways, because, yeah. There you go. Yeah, I was expecting that, which is just bad on my part because I was too greedy, and all I got out of it was a stock, which is the worst attachment in my opinion, because it only works if people miss. And so now the idea is to basically take DPS off the board. So we, is he in full cover? Yeah, he's in full cover. So basically, I think we're gonna go for the Advent officer because I can flank him basically. So we'll try to kill him, but I'm very skeptical. Okay, so we got a crit, which is very nice. This means I can kill him with a grenade, but I won't be able to hit the other one. And as you can see, both of my people have very bad shots on both of their people. I will probably can't I will probably move her into full cover and take the 45% shot, which I expect to stay pretty much the same. That's 49 now. Still bad. Because the 32% shot is just not gonna happen. The 49 is probably not gonna happen either. Well, okay, Commander is seemingly a little bit easier or more forgiving than the other one. So basically, we took some DPS off the board. I don't think I can reach him with a grenade. Maybe I will go really aggressive and put her here out of cover and just throw the grenade, because the grenade would be a. I'll just see how far she can throw her grenade. Yeah, I think we're good. I think I'll just move her here to get a. To definitely get a kill on the Advent Officer. If I miscalculate and she can't throw a grenade that far, she's probably gonna die. But she's not gonna. Maybe she's gonna die. I don't know. We'll see. But I hopefully didn't miscalculate. No, I didn't. Everything is fine. So we will grenade him and kill him to make sure we don't lose another soldier. Oh, there's only two pods in this difficulty. That's really nice. It was kind of stupid of me to lose that one soldier. And now basically all I have to do is plant the objective, and then I'm done with my first mission. So the first mission was okay, but I did lose the soldier, which is kind of dumb. But yeah, I just got too greedy with the attachment, which is meh. Okay, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.